Hi there, welcome to Pastor Luke Creation video tutorial. It's Christmas already and people are chilling, so there is a lot of noise in my area. I stay by roadside, so if you guys hear any noise, please forgive me, it's not my fault, and I want to share this video with you. Since we are entering into a new year, we'll be needing some calendar. So in this video we are going to learn how to design a desk calendar in Adobe Photoshop, and after that we are going to put it in this mock-up that we have right here, and I'm going to leave the link to download this mock-up and the resource file as well. So without further ado, let's jump right in. If you are new here, please make sure to click on the subscribe button, turn on the post notification bell so that if I put up a new video, you are going to get notified. So first of all, Control N for a new document, then we are going to use 5104 pixels by 3304 and resolution 300 RGB color, then click on create. A new canvas is going to open for us. Then from here I'm going to use this image, and please, I will leave this in the description below. You can download one for yourself, or you can use the link to download this specific image. Then I'm going to resize this and I'm going to put this one over here. All right, so from here with my background selected and with the help of my paint tool shortcut is G, I'll select my paint tool and make sure that the foreground color is black. Then I'll click once on my document with the background selected. All right, so from here I'm going to draw a shape around this. So I'll make a shape here, and with the shape I'm using the rectangle tool. Then I will change the color of this to a gray color, something like this is okay. Then I can see that there is a fill around here, so I will select no fill or no color for this. And I'm going to select both of these and I'll align this one to the center. Alright, so from here I would like to decrease the size of this a bit. And from here I'm going to draw another shape again using the rectangle tool, and the same thing, no fill for the stroke, and I'll use the gray color that I used over here, and I'm going to put this one over here. Then I'm going to increase its size a bit, Control G to make a duplicate, and then I'll reduce the size of that one, and then I'll try to align this one over here. You can see this one is not aligned. Okay, then I'll double click on the thumbnail to change the color to a black, click on enter to accept changes, and then I'm going to write here 2022. Then I'll drag this one over here and I'm going to use Work Sans font, so I'll highlight it all and I'm going to change this one to black so that the text stand out, and I'll change the color from the currently selected color and choose white, click on OK to accept changes. All right, so from here I'll select all of them, so I'll just drag over it, and I'm going to get the options at the top over here. So when you are on the move to, you get these options and I can align center. All right, so I would like to highlight this and drag this one a little bit up, then I can group this one, and also I can put this one also in a group, and I can also name the group, so maybe this one 2022 and the rest. All right, so from here I'll select my test tool again and I'm going to type January, but I'll type this one in short but also in caps. So with the same Web Sans, I'm going to use the light, extra light, then Control T for free transform, and I'm going to make this text stand out. Alright, so from here with the help of my rectangle tool, I'm going to draw a rectangle, and what we are up to is to bring the date. So I'm going to do it one after the other, no fill, and I'm going to select the gray color that we have been using. Alright, so here is going to be Monday. I'm using the calendar date on my iPhone and it starts from Monday. This is supposed to be 7. Okay, let me select these three, make sure it's aligned. Okay, so 6, 11 is 1. Drag, make a copy. Then I'll select all of them, reduce the size. So from here, I'm going to type my text and I'm going to reduce the size, which will fit that area for me. And then I'll change the color to black, which I'm going to see it very well. Then I'll change from the extra light to maybe regular. Then I'll make a duplicate like we did to the text. So with the duplicate, I hold down the Alt key on my keyboard. Then with the help of my mouse, I drag over it. Then I use the Shift key to keep it in a straight line. And I can use the arrow keys on my keyboard to center it. Before we move on to the next step, let me talk about today's sponsor. Skillshare is a huge learning platform with thousands of premium classes for creative and curious people. They have 1,000 of inspiring classes about graphic design, photography, illustration, filmmaking, freelancing, and much more. They offer 3,000 classes about Photoshop alone. One class that I really like is Photoshop Essentials, called from Danny Scott. He has almost 50 premium content for Photoshop class only. Unlike YouTube, Skillshare is 100% free of ads, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity take you. And for the first 1,000 people who join Skillshare from the link in the description below, will get 1 month free trial premium membership. Join Skillshare to boost your creative today. I personally have a class there, so when you join Skillshare using the link, you also have access to my class, 1 month free premium to explore more from the top creatives and me as well. Now let's get back to our tutorial. So before we move on, I would like to save my work, so Ctrl S to save, and I'll save this one as a PSD file and name it as desktop calendar, and then I'm going to save it on desktop for now. Click on save. Alright, from here we are going to add the date of 2022 January. First will start on Saturday, so with the help of my test tool, I'll type the number and I'll choose a white fill for this. Then I'll increase the font and I'll use the regular as well over here. Alright, so I would like to apply some changes to this. So with my text selected, I'm going to change from regular to light, and I will change this one to maybe 30 so that the text is going to be visible for me. Then from here, I'll type in the date, so 8, arrange it downwards, so 8, 15, 22, 29. And then I'm going to reduce the spacing between them, so let me take it down to maybe 50. Alright, so let me bring a ruler, and when it reaches here, it's okay for me, so let me bring it a little down, so that there is going to be enough space between the text. Then from here, I'll click on the accept changes, and I'm going to duplicate this one over here, make a duplicate also over here, another one, then the last two. Alright, so one thing that you can also do is that you can select all the text and you can click on this so that it will align everything so that the spaces is going to be the same. Alright, so from here I'm going to change the numbers, so I'll be just changing the date accordingly. So you can see here is 18, here will be 19, here will be 26, then 5, so here will be 6, 13, 20, then 27. Then I move up to the next, Next, 28. And I think this one is okay. So this one will go to 9, 16, 23, 24, and you can see here is 30th. And then we will have our last date over here as 31st. So because of this, I would like to push this one a little bit up. So I'll select all of the text and change the spacing to 55. And then I'm very okay with this. All right, so from here, what I will do next is that, let me change this one to second. With the help of my rectangle tool, I'm going to draw a line, just a tiny line to separate these things. I'm drawing just a tiny line so that it will separate the text for me. So let me see how the line came out. So I think even this one is big. Alright, so here is my line. I'm going to make a duplicate. So with my line selected, Ctrl J to make a duplicate. Use the arrow key on my keyboard to separate them. Another Ctrl J to make a third one. And if I want them to move fast, then I will zoom out and I'm going to move this one. Ctrl J, move this one down. Then this one also, I can select all of them and I can make sure that all of them is centered very well. Then also I can type 1 over here. So we know January is 1, right? So let me change this one to extra bold and make this one a bit bigger. Then I'll bring the 1 over here. Then I'll move this one all the way to the last button. And then I'll reduce the opacity to 1. So you can see the opacity is 10 now. So this one stands for 1 as in January. All right, so from here, I'll just add my details like phone number, my logo and stuff, so you can quickly add these things and you'll be done with your design. Alright, so this is how simple you can design a calendar in Adobe Photoshop. So save the file and then select the last top layer. And we are going to create a stamp visible layer. So Ctrl Alt Shift plus E to create a stamp visible layer. Then with your desk calendar mockup open, find where it says place your design. Double click on the smart object and it's going to open a file for you. Hide the original design and let's bring our design in. So I'm going to center this, then I'll click on Ctrl S to save. When it's done, check out your mockup and you can see the final design. This is really amazing, right? Okay, so we can also open the next mockup, page 2, and we do the same thing. So drag this one over here, then align to the center. Ctrl S to save, and let's check that one also. All right, then I'll apply that one also to the last one, so you can do this one your own. Okay, so one thing that I know you can do for sure is that you can see the color over here. The color on the ring is green and we don't want green. So when you open the mockup, you just turn that one off, or you can double click and you change to a color that you think is suits you. So any color that you think is okay for you can select like black like this, or you can leave it as white. So this how very simple you can design a desk calendar in Adobe Photoshop. Please don't forget to leave this video a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't, and make sure you download the mockup using the link in the description below. And please don't forget to also join the first 1000 people on Skillshare. Thank you for watching this video to the end. Check your screen, the two videos we pick for you to enjoy next. We love you.